Hey, we're Blubbered Shoes.
And this is the Skins YouTube channel.
Yeah, the song is called An Animal, and it's the first single off our new album. And yeah, I don't know, we did it's more of a stripped back version we did today, so it's normally a lot more loud and raucous than that, but
it's about as stripped down as we can do it.
Yeah.
It's still kind of loud. Our new record is the first time we've self-produced the record, which we've been talking about doing for ages, but we finally sort of had the confidence to take that risk of not relying on anybody else to do anything. So we moved all our equipment to Berlin and lived there for sort of half of last year and just engineered and produced and wrote it and just did it all in Berlin ourselves. And that's partly why we've called it Blood Red Shoes, because we feel like it's the first time it's sort of a really accurate sort of photograph of actually us, like all the bad points and all the good points of us. It's like completely kind of naked version of Blood Red Shoes.
Fantastic. How have you brought to writing and recording music?
How are you writing and recording
how
it?
How do we approach it?
Well, it changes. On the last record, we kind of sat down together and played acoustic guitars and wrote songs in a kind of more classic songwriting way. But this album was just us jamming in a room, and a lot of the time we were just recording as we were going along, and some of it's just improvised stuff. So
yeah like really, an animal. Yeah. In fact.
So it really is just like a kind of jam between us, and yeah, we just kind of work it out as we go along, and then add lyrics and melodies and stuff.
I don't know if I'd call it a career plan.
Yeah, I don't think you'd thought about having a career in it, but always wanted to do it, probably from about the age of 8. I decided that's what I wanted to do.
Yeah, same for me. It's always something I wanted to do. I don't think I ever thought of it as like a career. If you want to have a career, don't start a band. Go and do something clever, yeah? Because it's difficult. But I think we both have the same attitude. We've always felt like it's the most important thing. So even if we weren't doing it like full time, we'd probably both be working shitty jobs and spending all our free time being in band.
Which anyway, we were doing in the beginning.
Which is what we were doing when we started.
Oh,
my career highlight of our career was right now. Now there's loads, because we're nearly 10 years old, so we've done a lot of stuff and been to a lot of places, and a lot of it is really cool, so it's kind of a privileged thing to get to do anyway.
I think in my head is like stuff like Reading and Leeds main stage, playing Rage Against the Machine in Paris, that was really awesome.
The Breeders asked us to play ATP a few years ago.
That's great.
That was really cool. I remember getting the email, and we lived together at the time, and Laura thought something really bad had happened because I like squealed because I read the email. I was like,
love to play with PJ Harvey.
Yeah.
I think I'd be intimidated, very intimidated, but I would love to do it.
Oh, but you'd probably be taller than her. So.
Do you know? And who else?
Dead or alive?
God, that's Elvis.
Ah, good one. Yeah, all right, I'll go with that. That's pretty good.
Touring, a lot.
Loads of touring. Possibly the most touring we've ever done. The album release tour is 10 weeks of touring over a lot of countries. I don't think we've done 10 weeks like that before. I think it's been more fragmented over a year.
Yeah.
So possibly the most, certainly the most countries we've ever been to.
Yeah.
And then, we've got a record, our new album, and then just basically just being a band still. It's actually not that different to what we've done every other year, only the songs are way better on this record. Thanks for listening to us, guys. Our new album, Blood Red Shoes, is out today, so you should go and get it.
Really, really large looking eyes to represent opening your eyes to different things and looking at the possibilities of your future and what you can do. I feel like a lot of teenagers